Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Sona Group of Institutions, we welcome everyone for the International Virtual Conference on Applied Science, Technology, Management, and Language Studies. This conference is organized with the objective of bringing together researchers, academicians, developers, and practitioners working in several domains like science, technology, management, and language studies. Let's begin the ceremony with Tamil Thai Valtu.
We request everyone to stand up for Tamil Thai Valtu.
நீனாலும் கடலுடுத்த நிலமடந்த செறிதொழுகும் சீனாலும் பகலமெனத் திடடட கண்டமெனில் தென்கடலும் அதிசிறந்த திராவிடனல் திருதாளும் தத்த சிறு திரைமுதலும் கலிந்தனரும் திலகமுமே திரும்பியும்
May we now invite Dr. S. Chandrasekhar, convener of this international conference, Dean R&Ds of this institution, to welcome the gathering.
Yeah, very good morning to one and all present here. Most respected and beloved Chairman, sir, respected Vice Chairmen, respected Principal, Directors, Deans, HODs, Professors, my dear staff colleagues and student friends. I am really privileged to have the pleasant task of welcoming the distinguished gathering in this great occasion. Today, the inaugural function of Virtual International Conference on Applied Science, Technology, Management and Language Studies, and it is really a good virtual platform to exhibit the technical talents of young bloods. It is one another proud day in the history of Sona College of Technology. Today's conference has participants participating from more than 15 countries across the world, making this conference a truly international conference in spirit. Yes, now we all experience an unprecedented situation with the global COVID-19 pandemic. A virus not visible to the naked eye has put the world on pause. It has put into question how and where to go from here. Due to the changing time caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, we encourage our participants to stay safe and maintain social distancing, as a result of which, this conference will be the first of many conferences in the future that will be conducted remotely, virtually, through the use of advanced digital communication technologies. This two-day event of international conference hosts many events such as special keynote sessions from esteemed professors of various top-class universities across the world, technical paper presentation sessions for the participants, and also the best paper awards in each session of the and we will be walking you through all the sessions in order to have a hassle-free and smooth event throughout the two-day conference. In this great occasion, I take this opportunity to extend my hearty welcome to all of you in this morning. Let me first welcome our chairman, sir, a charismatic leader and a dynamic administrator, and who has always stressed upon the importance of good basic education for the student community, and who has provided us with the required leadership for converting our plans into action. Welcome you, sir. I have immense pleasure in extending a warm welcome to our vice chairmen, Mr. Chako Valiyappa and Mr. Tyagu Valiyappa, whose affection and admiration towards Sona Group of Institutions is the real backbone of our college, and we always look forward for their support and guidance to achieve laurels. Welcome you, sir. I would like to extend a special welcome to our chief guest of honor, Professor Kumar Murthy, Director, Fields Institute for Research in Mathematical Sciences, University of Toronto, who will be joining with us and speaking later today evening by 6:30 p.m. Professor will deliver a lecture on the mathematics of information technology, the road ahead. And in this great occasion, I welcome Professor Kumar Murthy, who has readily accepted our invitation to act as a chief guest of this conference. Let me extend my hearty welcome to our respected principal, who is a person with a vision to take the education of our college to the global level, which has made a remarkable spurt in making the college as the most preferred one in this region. Welcome you, sir. I would also like to welcome the principals of Sona Group of Institutions who have joined through Zoom online meeting, the principal of Tyagaraja Polytechnic College, the principal of Sona College of Arts and Science, and the without the hard work and dedication of our HODs, coordinators, co-coordinators, faculty and students team of each department who worked tirelessly from day one to make today a reality. I extend my hearty welcome to all our HODs and faculty and students in this great occasion. Last but not least, I would like to welcome the guest, invitees, press and media for this great function. I would like to conclude my speech by encouraging the delegates to participate with an increasing number of activities and discussions through the digital platforms for the next 2 days. I wish everyone a successful, safe and fruitful conference. Once again, I welcome you all for this function. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your warm welcoming. Now let's have a glimpse of Sona College.
Sona College of Technology is situated in Salem, a South Indian town not quite regarded as one of the metros. It is a part of the Sona group of institutions and also one of the fastest growing technical institutions in the region. In spite of its location in a tier 2 town, the college has excellent facilities for research and development. Its world-class infrastructure is ideally suited for both academic and research and development activities.
Similarly, we've taken the R&D deep into the ocean. We work with the Indian Institute of Ocean Technology in terms of providing them underwater robots and motors. The unique aspect, one example in this regard, is the blackboard implementation. We are the first institution in the country to have given blackboard, which is one of the world's largest e-learning platforms.
So Sona is holistic learning. When you join Sona, you as a student, you're focused on not only education, but skilling, enjoyment, as well as sports and entertainment. So this, for one, gives you the opportunity to look at an international standard of learning and skilling with the immense technology and the faculty that we have. One would say it's the best place to study in the country. Sona, with its presence, as a large sports ground in the heart of Salem, has focus right now with the biggest of brands across Europe and Australia to bring them into Salem.
Sona has A-grade accreditation by NAC and all of its eligible programs NBA accreditation. The college has a sprawling campus with bright and airy classrooms. Sona is also a proud recipient of the AICTE CII Awards for Best Industry-Linked Technical Institution. Sona College's green building, the first for an educational institution in India, is awarded the highest 5-star rating by Griha. President Abdul Kalam inaugurated Sona's 36 advanced research centers during the Golden Jubilee celebrations of the Sona Group.
The R&D facilities of Sona College of Technology and innovative projects that we have undertaken in the electricals, electronics, IT, nanoscience, and technology and biotechnology. Also, I witnessed the CD and the ISRO collaborative projects, which are engaged in making subsystems and made a project community model for spacecraft mechanism and rocket missile control mechanism and an interplanetary satellite to be sent to fly in 2000. So I would suggest for all of you, I call it Sona. Sona Rock, this place is insulated and using the physical connectivity, electronic connectivity, knowledge activity and then the economic activity will come. So it will require Sona complex, Sona Pura complex.
The research, what really they're targeting, mainly to keep it in indigenization of the many, many, very, very critical technology. It will be useful for many sectors of the in the country, either the space or commercial purpose or societal applications. And I'm sure that the Sona College is going to contribute in a major way in the future India, making India, future India. They are going to make a major way.
Going around a few places, then convocation, that is graduation ceremony, followed by that visit to some of the excellent research and labs which are centers of excellence. Now this work which you are carrying out with village people with disabilities, women, in order to empower them through technology. Otherwise, many times we have normal type of activities where we go to the village and carry out Swachhata Abhiyan or give them lessons in education. These are all many institutions keep doing it. But what is significant and important is the advancements that are happening in technology. How do we make use of them to train people in the villages, women, physically challenged, and by empowering them, increase their income, help them to lead a good life. You know, that is what was exciting in this particular room, whatever I have seen. So this WIT has done a wonderful job and I hope they will continue to do it and provide inspiration to other colleges also to do similar things in their neighborhood. You know, whatever you are doing is based on the requirements of this region. Maybe in Maharashtra, some other requirement. Andhra, there is some other requirement. UP, there is some other requirement. Northeast, there may be a different requirement. But the basic idea of making use of technology.
How far you want to grow? How far you want to fly? Sky is the limit. This Sona College is right there in the sky. Go up to that, above that. Way to go to that sensor. Way to reach that satellite. I'm very happy it is on the sky, it is under the sea.
I was impressed by many of the research projects happening there, including the custom-built BLDC motors for ISRO, green-synthesized nanomaterials for solar cells and photovoltaics, and image processing. I was so impressed that we started doing a collaborative project with Sona College for building biomedical devices where Sona is taking a lead in the medical image processing side.
Thank you.
Sona College of Technology is situated in a South Indian town, not quite regarded as
light symbolizes good life and prosperity to shine. I request the dignitaries to enlighten this day by lighting the kuthvilakku. I request our beloved chairman, vice chairman, and principal to join the lighting.
Thank you, dignitaries. We are happy to invite our charismatic and versatile leader, our beloved principal, Dr. S.R.R. Sendil Kumar, to present the inaugural address.
Honorable Chairman, Sri C. Valiappa, Dynamic Vice Chairman, Mr. Choko Valiappa and Mr. Tyagu Valiappa. Today's chief guest, Professor Kumar Murthy, who is the Director for Fields Institute of Research in Mathematical Science, University of Toronto. Convener of this international conference and Dean for Research and Development in our Sona College of Technology, Dr. Chandrasekhar, Dr. Satyabhama, Deans, heads of various departments, my dear colleagues, delegates across globe, presenters across globe and various keynote speakers from more than 15 countries, my dearest student friends, ladies and gentlemen, press and media, good morning to every one of you. It gives me great pleasure to be a part of this international event, which is, in fact, for the first time, we are conducting it virtually. This inauguration of the International Virtual Conference on Applied Science, Technology, Management, and Language Studies, ASTMLS 2020, has been, thought of, and we have been working for the last 10 months from almost all the departments. And at this point of time, I take this opportunity to thank our dedicated management, especially, the chairman and both the vice chairman, for having sanctioned the funds for organizing this program. And of course, during this pandemic period alone, we could able to attract a lot of funds in terms of organizing such kind of programs for the benefit of all the teaching community and the trainers and the researchers. Through All India Council for Technical Education alone, we could able to attract more than 25 lakhs of funds, and we are progressing in terms of conducting 3 STTPs, that is known as short-term training programs, and 1 faculty development program, through which it's about 16 programs which we have almost, we are in the verge of completing this, all these 16 programs, and through which more than 2,000 faculty members, it's a very good, thing what we have done through our institution. More than 2,000 people from teaching, community, they are benefited out of these programs. And all those programs were sponsored either by the government or All India Council for Technical Education or, other funding agencies. Whereas this virtual international conference has been completely funded by our management. And of course, our educational journey started way back in 1958, and almost 63 years of our relentless service in this education has made our the first institution, which is known as Tyagaraja Polytechnic College, to be the India's topmost polytechnic college available. That's the big pride for our entire Sona group of institutions. And during this 63 years of time, we have not stopped only with one institution. And of course, we started with Polytechnic College. Then we have started this Sona College of Technology in the year 1997. And after that, Sona College of Arts and Science 3 years before. And last year, we have started Sona Public School. And this year, we are starting Sona Medical College for the naturopathy and yoga. So these are the different educational institutions we are running successfully for the last 63 years. And during these years, we could able to attract a lot of awards for the entire group of institutions, and especially for the Sona group of Sona College of Technology. You would have seen this in our profile video. And more than that, the philanthropical activities of our management, has given us one best award given by the Indian government, which is what is known as Vishwakarma Award, that has been awarded to our chairman, Sri C. Valliappa, from the central government of India, for the work what we have contributed to this entire society. For the 2 states, I would say that Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, for more than 40 million of Indian rupees, sponsored, especially from our college management, in terms of helping the entire people of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka during this difficult time, Corona, period. And of course, we have brought in 36 research centers over here, and through it, we could able to connect with ISRO, National Institute of Ocean Technology, Titan Industries, and with respect to various countries like South Korea, Sultanate of Oman, and Japan, and whatnot. You know, many countries are also, we are connected with various research organizations, and we could able to achieve a lot of the products. I mean, we could able to do a lot of research in almost all the areas. You take up any topic and, you know, you can find one or two research centers available over here. And through it, you know, almost this region from entire Tamil Nadu, I would say that, you know, many people, those who are into research, they are utilizing this facility available over here. And our management is always showing interest in terms of, you know, serving the society. So in that way, we always welcome any person who is having an idea, because, we have got an entrepreneurship center, and through which ideathon, activities are mostly we are concentrating. And for the last one and a half months, we have started one program, what is called as Power On Me, wherein any person, whether he is an illiterate or sometimes he may be a researcher in a different field, for that matter, whomever it may be, anybody is having idea, you know, those members are invited over here. And with respect to the anything needed for them in terms of mentoring them, to make their ideas into a prototype, or from prototype into a product, or from a product to a successful enterprise. All such facilities are available over here through various research centers and various laboratories. And, the expertise available from our faculty members, more than 160 people. And for our group of institutions, if you say more than 200, people, they have PhDs, and they have PhD doctorates. And thereby, any person who is approaching us in terms of, developing their career in the research field, and we are always encouraging them and helping them by all means. And of course, our management is also giving them seed funds, or angel funding is also available from our management. And I request all the people, those who have joined for this program through virtually, and of course, physically over here, I am requesting them to utilize this kind of opportunity for them to move forward. And today, with this small introduction, I would like to go on to this international conference. And this international conference has been planned in a multidisciplinary way. Normally, we used to conduct it in a particular domain or particular area, wherein we conduct. Whereas, since it is a pandemic, and anybody for that matter from their own places, they can join for this conference. So we thought that let us have it interdisciplinary way, so that the people, those who are into civil engineering, they can look into what is happening into IoT or artificial intelligence or data analytics or automobile engineering, so that they can really, because the people, those who are into research, now they will also accept my point that if you do research in a particular domain, it is not going to be a welcoming one. And we will not get a fruitful results out of it. In fact, we are supposed to connect with various other disciplines and domains, and we could able to bring the results in such a way that, which is matching with the today's technology, which the entire world is working now with. So this multidisciplinary conference, international conference, we are organizing for the first time. in the virtual mode. And of course, we have done a lot of international conferences, and always, whenever we organize international conference, we used to get overwhelming response across globe. And in that way, I should congratulate the entire team, those who have, organized this program, because more than 600 technical papers, research papers we have received, more than 600 papers. It is not that easy. In any international conference, we can see about 100 to 125 papers, whereas, here we have received 600, out of which, we have got, plagiarism checking software, and of course, a very big team of, the expert members who scrutinized the value, and a very big team of, the expert members who scrutinized the value, the papers quality, and we used the Turnitin software, which is available in our campus for all our researchers, to write their papers and publish it in various journals. And that has been used for scrutinizing the papers, and out of which, around 500 papers. I'm very glad to say that, in this two-day international conference, it's about 500 papers are going to be, presented over here through nearly 52 sessions. 52 sessions, which we are going to have it for this all domains in these two areas. And of course, one interesting thing is, we could able to attract 17 keynote speakers, and of course, out of which are more than 13, I think it is exactly 15 keynote speakers are from various countries, nearly 15 countries they are joining today and tomorrow. And the countries are like USA, Canada, UK, Italy, Japan, Hong Kong, South Korea, Romania, Oman, Sri Lanka, and Dubai. So this is a great achievement. That is what the advantage of, conducting these kind of programs. And henceforth, we are supposed to, this pandemic has given us a lesson that, with this kind of virtual programs, we could able to connect more number of intellectuals from across globe, real time across globe. When we said, our chairman, sir, we are organizing international conference, he said, whether are we getting any participants from other countries? That is what, because in our experience, it's very difficult for them to, travel across from their country to our country, and, their arrangements, all such things are very difficult. Whereas I'm very happy to inform you, sir, that 15 countries, from 15 countries, the participants have joined, and I should thank the organizers for that. And these 52 sessions are going to be organized through 12 parallel sessions, and these 17 keynote sessions, which are going to happen on these major themes like electric vehicle technology, smart wearable technology, nanotechnology, smart grids and renewable energy technology, artificial intelligence, blockchain technology, computational intelligence, embedded and IoT technology, cyber technology, business communications, image processing, VLSI design, wireless communication systems, exploring language teaching, data mining, and machine learning. If you run through these titles, the keynote lectures, what people are going to give, these topics are the talk of the day from the entire globe. The entire globe is looking or working in these areas. This is actually going to change the entire, working principles with any field in the next 5 years of time. I hope, we all would have seen how the world has changed just a decade before and now, how the world has changed. And within another 5 years, I am very confident that this is again going to go into another fold. The change is going to be very high during this next 5 years, and for which all the researchers, all the teaching fraternity, all the students community, those who are working in this area should be given with certain knowledge in this area so that, you know, they may get a little spark through this 2 days program, through the keynote lectures, whatever people are giving. And from that spark, if they can take it forward, and definitely I'm confident that, you know, they are going to bring a lot of laurels to this entire world, entire, you know, human community. And see, actually, we have not missed out even a single field for that matter. You know, we have invited papers on these areas, these entire areas. And for the benefit of the researchers, you know, what we have done this time, we could able to connect with the 10 very important journals, which are all Scopus indexed journals, which we are all connected. And, you know, I would like to tell you all that almost all the 500 papers are going to be published in the in these journals. For example, Journal of Webology, Material Science and Engineering, Journal of Molecular and Clinical Medicine, Mathematical Scientific Journal, Journal of Archaeology, Journal of Physics, Journal of Communication Technology, Journal on Microelectronics, Journal on Soft Computing, Journal on Image and Video Processing. So these are the you know, journals which we are connected, and definitely all the papers which they are going to present in this 2-day conference are going to be published, and which is really going to help us. And from Sona College of Technology alone, during 2 months before, during two months before we organized, along with ICT Academy, a big event, 3 international conferences, and in which, you know, more than 180 papers we could able to, you know, present only from our college, you know, members. And those 180 papers have been published, and of course it is going to be published in the next 1 month time in UGC indexed journals. And I should say only one point before I conclude, that the kind of the management team available here, they are, you know, always giving a lot of importance for the people to do research. Normally, in any college, the management will be, you know, like they'll have bird's eye view only. They'll be seeing what is happening. Whereas here, in this, because, you know, it is fourth generation, they are working in this education field. And they go into the micro level, you know, discussions. And they always come and give us a lot of, you know, problem statements for our researchers to get involved, especially for that matter, you know, Mr. Chaku Waliappa, who is available here today. And, you know, he used to be almost every day in the country. That's the kind of, you know, the activity he is involved. And of course, he is, you know, leading a very big organization, which is called as V Technologies, and which is you know, headquartered in Bangalore, and they have got their centers at New York, you know, Chennai, Salem, across India also. They have got a special setup called Sona Yukti, more than, you know, 15 centers they have formed. And one point I have to tell, that this entire education fraternity, or teaching fraternity, that during this pandemic, you know, people are really struggling in terms of, you know, knowledge transfer, in terms of teaching, and in terms of doing assessments, conducting exams. All these things are really big problem. And our visionary leader, Mr. Chaku Waliappa, has thought of this particular problem at the beginning of this pandemic. And of course, you know, he had already one package, what is called as Hire Me, which was used to, you know, develop the students' skills, and also to connect the, you know, young minds with the industries through the portal, what is called as Hire Me. And that Hire Me has been immediately altered, and, you know, has been added with some other features, so that Hire Me is helping now in India more than 48 universities in terms of conducting their, you know, assessments, especially semester, all these, you know, portals, whatever the technical tools available, you know, over and above. This has got a great quality of, you know, conducting examinations in a proctored way. And many universities, they accepted this particular, you know, portal, and they are using, and in fact, you know, our group of institutions entirely, they are using it. So we could not, we did not see even a single lapse in terms of, you know, conducting our classes or conducting the university examinations at this point of time. From the entire, you know, fraternity of the teaching members, I would like to say big thanks to our Choko Valliappa. Give a big round of applause. Really, it is a really good thing which we have received from Mr. Choko Valliappa. And initially, initially what was planned for connecting the students who are passing out from any educational portal, it was a big problem for them to get connected with the industry, to join with the industry as a member of their firm. Whereas after bringing this, you know, more than 1 lakh students have benefited by registering their, you know, resumes and, you know, their bio videos over there in that. And through that, many industries are connected and they are taking them on board. And for that matter, another vice chairman, Mr. Thyaku Valliappa, who could not join us today, he is very busy in terms of, you know, setting up of his medical institution here in Salem, especially after seeing this pandemic, to help the, you know, general public. You know, he thought that our Indian, medicine system, which will definitely, you know, give a good health for all the people, and in that way, he thought, and within, about 6 months' time, he planned everything and he has started, and today he is there in that institution for a particular, committee visit. And I should thank him also, because with this intervention, you know, we could able to get one facility which is called as Sona Garage, like Google, any other top-level companies, they started from garage. And similarly, to inform our students that your ideas also can become like a Google, today's Google, right? And for that, we have given 10,000 square feet space from the building what our chairman has designed, because our chairman is always from management side, but still he's not a civil engineer, but he's, I would say that I am a civil engineer. I can very well say that, you know, he is, I can look at the top level of any civil engineers, I would say. Any for that matter, even 10 lakh square feet building, if you are giving on a single drawing sheet, he could able to understand what is there in each and every corner. And he always come out with solution or alternate ideas, you know, with which if anybody has visited, you know, the people, those who are joined across globe, if you are getting an opportunity to visit our campus, you would really appreciate the kind of, you know, ideas, you know, of our chairman of building buildings over here in our campus. It's all really good, and out of because of that, you know, we could be able to achieve lot of awards from Indian government. Sara has given 10,000 square feet for the Sona Garage. From that, you know, Salem's tallest tower, which is almost in the verge of completing, in that, Sara has given 10,000 square feet of space, and people are going to utilize that. So I am really glad to be a part of time. I'm part of this, conference. I don't want to take much of your time. I'm really glad and very, very happy. And at this point of time, I once again congratulate and thank the entire the committee, which is led by Dr. Chandrasekhar, you know, for having organized this wonderful program for the benefit of all the researchers. And I welcome every one of the person who from this 500, not only this 500, or more than that, you know, more than 500 people, they are, you know, attending this as a participant, just to understand what is happening across these fields. and I welcome every one of them to be available for this two-day session. You are not limited to only the domain what you have registered. You are given freedom to, you know, go on to every session, any session for that matter, and try to interact with the people and get a little spark or enhance the research work, whatever you are doing as on date through these, you know, 2 days activities. I wish every one of you very good luck and good time. And I would like to come back to you tomorrow evening, maybe for the valedictory program. And I am very glad to announce that, you know, we are planning to select 48 best papers from all these sessions. 48 best papers are going to be awarded tomorrow evening for that program. I would like to join again. Till then, goodbye to everyone. And have a wonderful, you know, international conference for every one of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now we invite our respected chairman and vice chairman and a beloved principal to release the conference proceeding CD. Thank you, dignitaries. May we now invite our vibrant Vice Chairman, Mr. Chakovalyappa, to share a few words.
Very good morning and good evening to all of you. I have to say good evening as well because there are 13 countries which are participating in this, and a lot of them may be towards their evening. So it's indeed a great way to connect today in this virtual platform. Respected Chairman, Principal Dr. Sendal Kumar, Dean Research Dr. Chandrasekhar, and Dean Admissions Dr. Satyabhama, my dear friend Dr. Kumar Murthy from Fields Institute, which is the foremost institute for maths. Welcome, sir. Hope to see, hear you this evening. I mean, dignitaries in this room, as well as all the academicians and researchers around the world. So it's indeed a good topic to be talking today in terms of where we talk about technology, we talk about applied sciences, we talk about management, and we talk about language. When all of these things come together, you have a true symphony of science. So because what the world needs is a symphony of science, because we need a complete, everyone coming in from all directions to solve the problems. Because as we know, the IoT, the Internet of Things, is something which is well known today, but the IoT is also the integration of technology. So we need this because, the problems are getting multidimensional, and how do you tackle multidimensional problems through multidimensional approach? So that's how I think this conference is truly unique in its space. So hopefully next year when you have this, we will have this conference in Aircard, and we will get more and more participants coming from around the world to Aircard. Because when I conceived this thought of getting, I was actually in Davos in Switzerland. In this January, and where they had, it's a small town, and it's probably one third of Aircard, but yet it had the entire firepower of the world top leaders converging to that small city, small town, or small village. And you had everyone from the US American president to journalists, to researchers, to scholars, to students. And so I think something like that, if we host it in Erkad and get everyone, different thought leaders into a two, three-day conference in Erkad and deliberate different things, I think that will be a good one. So post-COVID, I think next year, it will be a great one to meet in December in a cold, cold environment, thinking warm thoughts. I think this conference, I congratulate all the organizers, Professor Chandrasekhar and the entire team here, because getting over 500-600 people on a virtual platform right now around the world is the ideal thing to do. It's a smart thing to do, because if you look around the world, there are 52 sessions which are happening today and tomorrow, and these 52 sessions are and will have 48 best papers. Okay, and then so what the world needs today post COVID? COVID is the best example of how all of this, what we are talking, UK and other countries have already started implementing and actually delivering the vaccine to people in less than 7 to 9 months from March to now. If you see, maybe the pharmacy companies had a longer tailwind, but all said, if you can compress 5 years to 9 months, that shows the acceleration of technology. I think all of us as researchers, we need to make sure that we keep abreast with more. I'm sure a lot of the researchers who are listening today and around the world would start looking at the humanitarian and the societal needs of research much more today. So I'm happy that we at Sona and all the staff and faculty here have had the humane side of research. So be it WTP, Women Technology Park, taking technology to the rural areas and helping women in underprivileged communities come out and learn. That's what President Kalam had given us the task. Be it taking that, or making waste into wealth. That is another thing which we have excelled. Our civil engineering department has taken waste and made it into wealth. So in terms of taking industrial waste, so that's another nice thing. And I'm also happy that during the pandemic, we were able to launch an app called WeTrace. And WeTrace is now being used by 1 million employees around, we are very happy to say that right from the largest car manufacturer in India, Maruti, is using a product which was developed by our IT team and a bunch of students. We had conceived it, but the students did the first pilot, and that is being used by Maruti. So that's another great thing. Another great synergy is how our departments came together working with DRDO in terms of developing a seam sealing machine. The seam sealing machine was a big problem for that. So DRDO came up with the problem. And so our fashion technology team, our mechanical team, with an industrial partner, and the electrical team came in together, because it was a true confluence of technology, engineering, and to develop a product. And I'm also happy post-COVID that even the students have come forward to look at societal needs. And we were very happy that two of our teams, both Tyagaraja Polytechnic and Sona College, won the Smart India Hackathon. That is a student problem which Prime Minister Modi launched. And we were very happy that from that factor too. And also the concepts of this, we're looking to the program, some of the things are very, very needed. Wearable technology, because wearable technology is something that is going to be more and more prevalent. So today we are having an oximeter. I'm sure you will soon have a device which will automatically tell you the oximeter on a continuous basis. You wouldn't need to have that. Just like how you're having a heart rate sensor in smart watches today. So I'm sure more and more technologies will happen. And EV as well, electronic vehicles and mobility, is going to be changing and transforming the way we know it. So if you go ask your grandparents who used the bullock cart, how they changed from bullock cart to the cars are, that's how the technology that our the generation Z is going to see. So one is they're going to see the transition from gasoline vehicles to electric and from driver to driverless cars. So that's the technology we are all going to see within 10, 20 years. It's already there in the US. People are using it. Maybe it may take a longer time to come to India, but I think so those things are going to be progressing. So I think we are in an exciting time, and I'm sure this conference will lead us into thinking more of how the future may be and what the future will be. And I'm also very happy that the staff all over, we've seen an increase in having publications and papers in the last couple of months. So if you allow people the time that, like, you know, you constrain people in a room and have lockdowns and things like that, the mind is wandering. So, like, you know, I'm very one of the favorite quotes of mine is like, two men sit in a prison and one looks at the bars, the other looks at the stars. And I'm sure COVID has given us the opportunity of not looking at the bars, the thinking that we are in the four walls constrained, but look at the stars, because that's where technology can go. Thank you.
Mr. Tiago Valyappa to address the gathering.
Yeah, am I audible? Hello. Good morning.
Please do mutually connect it to us.
Yeah, respected chairman, respected principal, Choco vice chairman, and Chandrasekhar Dean, and Dr. Satyavama. I'm just driving, so I'm just trying to keep it as short as possible. But then, what the kind of connect to students as well as society. As we speak, I think we all are very well aware that the pandemic has kind of changed the way we think and we do things. And the fact that the 5G network is on the threshold of starting or taking over, technology is something which can enable on a call on a car. Who would have thought 20 years ago this can happen? And another 20 years, you can be rest assured that the conferences will be on a different platform altogether, and God knows where it can go. So the 5G network probably would become a 20G network very soon. But then what this would enable is technology to go forward. At the same time, the pandemic has brought us to a kind of a focus that the health is a new wealth, and nature is far more stable than chemical, because natural health care is something which can actually make a big, big difference than chemical health care. So first, you would like to use both the options of both chemical and natural health care. At the same time, connecting nature to technology is something which is not heard of or not thought of. So this is where I think the chemical engineering, through molecular biology, through these kind of areas are going to grow very rapidly. And certainly this can be a topic that we should go out for the next conference, because if it's to India, both in terms of healthcare as well as in terms of medical as well as technology. Coming to the conference, which is going on now, 5 hours, is a great experience. And I think this being a pandemic period, we've got, and as we speak, the third point I just wanted to mention before I close, applied technology through applied engineering as well as, society growth. As you would have heard, Abdul Kalam was, I think his video was played in the beginning of this program. He had spoken this about 11 or 12 years ago at Sona. Everything needs to be connected to the growth and development of society. And that is where I think at Sona, we're very well focused and connected in this We were talking about the pandemic and the various medicines or the various instruments and products that we have created. I think one of the products we created within a span of, say, maybe about a month or so is the medicine called Sesvita. It's brought out about 125 people out of coronavirus. It is not an immunity device, but it is a solution which protects and cures and cleans the system of any gland in the face area and the throat area. And this has been brought into a product and it has been sold now extensively and both in retail as well as wholesale. So I think this is patented as well. So this is something which goes back to the steaming days of Siddha medicines, which were practiced maybe 4,000 years ago or more, older than that. So our simple solutions are something which we always take forward. We always think it's very difficult. But then if you really see, we're talking about artificial intelligence. The natural intelligence, which is already there, needs to be tapped. And then the artificial intelligence can, you know, kick in. So with these words, I think I would leave the experts to talk for the next couple of days. And I'm sure that the outcomes of this would be something that we'd be all very, you know, we'll take home a lot more knowledge than what we start today as well. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thoughts. Our chairman is the one who always believes the right thinking embedded with right knowledge will help to succeed in the chosen field.
எல்லோருக்கும் வணக்கம். என்ன தோ இட்ஸ் இன்டர்நேஷனல் கான்ஃபரன்ஸ், தமிழில் பேசுறேன்னு நினைக்கிறீங்களா? Even our Prime Minister talks in Hindi everywhere he goes. Mr. Principal Sindhil Kumar, Dean Chandrasekhar, Vice Chairman Chukku, and other deans, professors, and faculty members, students. It gives me a great pleasure to be here on this international seminar. And I think this is the first time I'm seeing the language studies also, this type of international conference. And in a way, I don't know how you are selected today. It is a great poet, Subramanya Bharati's birthday. So I should say he was one of the motivators for research in India. And as way back in 90s, radio kadaiyadhu. Then there was no radio. Then he said that the people talking in Berlin onwards, people have started the radio and etc. So I'm happy to note so big a success for this. And I think whether you expected this big this number of papers or you are happy you have received more. We expected. Then you should have been more also. Okay, next time you try to get more. About 600 papers. And I was told about nearly 500 papers accepted. And the dean was happy to mention many of the topics and other things. Principal has explained in a very detailed way, so I need not go again. And business communication also you have already added this time. And this type of research, something we have to note, take a note of it. The quality of the native cow's milk into the hybrid milk also. This is not the only thing. You take brinjal. They say the native brinjal is much better and tasty. So while we do, why can't we take that thing also? And I'm not a non-vegetarian. Chicken, they say it brings a lot of health, the they give some enzyme and other things. So these things should be taken into care. Again, when we go for higher production and other researches, sometimes we don't give that much attention to the quality and the wastage. The affordability becomes more than the wastage. We don't bother to have a more wastage. That should not be there. As principal was telling about my passion to the building, see, it has come in the genes, I should say. Karamathu Thyagarajachari was a great architect. Today, if you go and see any of his buildings, it will have a similarity and it will stand apart from other buildings. Like that, our founder chairman, my father Chokalingam, he is also a great taskmaster, and then he constructed a lot of buildings. And in 1960, we constructed a building at Bangalore with 120 feet folded plate RCC without a column, 120 by 500. Then when I wanted to expand in 1975, then father said, we did 120, you better it. Then I went to Indian Social, sat there with the architects, and then designed 150. Today it is not that difficult, but those days we did 155.
RMC Road, near KEB office.
I used to have my civil department fully equipped. Sometimes we say that 5% wastage we allow. That doesn't mean the contractor should waste 5%. He should see how he can do it within 1%, within 1%. And the quality, it's really, you construct so well. But finally, the quality aspect, the skill, we have to do the skill also. I think we should add skill also in the research. So, anyway, I'm happy more than 500 participants are there. And I don't want to take much time. And again, I would like to end with a Kannadasan's song in 1960s, I should say. Parabe Kandan, Vimanam Padaitan. பாய மீன்களில் படையினை கண்டான், எதிரொலி கேட்டான், வானொலி படைத்தான், கடைசியில் எதனை கண்டான்னு சொல்வார். இவ்வளவு பண்ணிட்டு ஏரோப்ளேன் அண்ட் பாயும் மீன்களில் படையினை கண்டான், எதிரொலி கேட்டான், எக்கோ இயர்ஸ் டெவலப்ட் ரேடியோ. லைக் தட் இட் ஷுட் வி ஷுட் என்ஜாய் தி டெவலப்மெண்ட்ஸ். இட் ஷுட் நாட் கம் இன் த வே ஆஃப் த லைஃப். தட் இஸ் அ திங் யூ வாண்ட் டு mention. So again, Tiago was telling, nobody would have thought that while going in the car, he can attend an international conference. I used to say, this communication, we used to go to Erkad about 50 years back, and again, there were calls. If you put a call from Erkad, it's very difficult to get it sale up. The same thing for me. My Bangalore also, my mill was about 20 kilometers away, but it was a separate exchange. So we used to put a call, then make it urgent, then make it lightning. Well, with the lightning call only, we used to get a call for 20 kilometers. So today, anywhere in the world, you can talk at any time within seconds. And again, government also should change their some of their practices. Earlier, they used to have a telegram that's gone completely, and trunk booking. Trunk booking, you would not have seen the trunk booking. It used to be 180 trunk booking, and inquiries 181. And international booking was something like 186 or some such thing. I don't know whether it is there, still asking that. Today, everybody can talk. So this government also should come out with some of the changes. And even yesterday we were talking to the Vice Chancellor of Periyar University, Arts College principal was telling that computer 2000 version, huh? The computer, they were having 2000 versions, so these things should be changed. So I congratulate Chandrasekhar and his team for making this happen, and then, and even at the pandemic in such a big way. All the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for enlightening us with your words. May we now invite Dr. B. Satyabhama, Dean Admissions and Head of Computer Science Department, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Pleasant morning, one and all present here. So I thought I will be the first person to say about Subramanya Bharathiyar's birthday. But before that, our chairman has spoke about him. So always our chairman and vice chairman, they will be talking unique things. I thought I'll be the unique person talking about Subramanya Bharathiyar. And as our chairman said, in his songs, he always connect technology, science, and business. And that's why our Indian people are very powerful. And as he imagined and visualized, even one of our, they are contributing very much to the technology. So with such technological world, I'm very happy to render the vote of thanks. And also it's a nice gesture to share the thanks to all the people, those who have contributed enormously in this international conference. And Sona is growing much, much in a bigger way. And that is because of our management, their thoughtfulness and their thinking. Because of that, we are getting very good guidance and support. And that's why we are leading in the technology world. And thank you, sir, for your marvelous and wonderful. There are captains. So we have nice captains with us, our principal and Polytechnic principal, Karthikeyan sir, and Kadanava sir. So they are all supporting us to reach our destination appropriately. Thank you for your overwhelming support in organizing this conference, sir. Thank you, sirs. And next, in order to be reaching the destination sharply and quickly, so all our deans and HODs and the conference coordinators have taken a right decision and right path. And that's why we are here today and we are enjoying. And I would like to thank our chief guest of the day, Dr. Kumar Murthy, a legendary mathematician, because our vice chairman has rightly identified a mathematician, because math is the root of the engineering. So thank you, sir. And I would like to thank all our coordinators who has put immense efforts in students. And I would like to thank all our supporting staff who has rendered enough services and support in organizing this digital conference in a wonderful way. Thank you all. And I would like to thank all the present media, Sona Varsity, for who have selected very, very consciously and with full efforts. So definitely they will get very good ideas about their research. So I would like to thank all the jury members too, and all the best to all of us. And we will have a wonderful conference in these 2 days. So thank you, one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. We wind up this inaugural function with
Thank you.